guys, it's Ellie and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to share some great mystery reads with you guys. And even though mystery is not my favorite genre, I have read some great books in this genre by various authors and surrounding various sleuths and detectives who are so dashing, intellectual and awesome. And in this video, I'm going to share some of them. The very first name that comes to anybody's mind while speaking of detectives is obviously Sherlock Holmes.
William Sherlock, Scott Holmes. High functioning sociopath. Welcome to my world.
Sherlock Holmes has been getting even more feedback and love right now because of this series on Netflix, I guess. But read the original books or listen to the audiobooks because they are just not imitable, and I don't think the show comes near the real book. And I have a copy of Arthur Conan Doyle's The Casebook of Sherlock Holmes, but I suggest that you can get Prajapati Books version because it has all the short stories and novels. It's so fat and it is available at just $3.95. I'll attach a link in the description below. But the thing is that if you pick up Sherlock Holmes, if you are not accustomed with reading English, you will find it very difficult. Because when I started reading Sherlock Holmes in class 9, I could not understand beyond one page. I could not. I tried real hard. I just couldn't. It was not for me. I think the reason is that the language is sort of complicated for a beginner, and in that case I'll recommend you guys to read Agatha Christie. Now the thing is, I have read only one book by Agatha Christie, and that is Murder on the Orient Express. I liked it, but the thing is, I don't think I'm gonna pick up any Agatha Christie ever again because I did not feel that connect with it that I felt with Sherlock Holmes. A lot of people love Hercule Poirot, and I'm so sorry if my opinion is bad, but that's just the thing. I did not connect with him like I did with Sherlock, and a lot of people told me that this is probably not the very good choice for the first time, but I feel that it was. A lot of people told me that it was probably because this is not a good book for a beginner who's starting reading Agatha Christie for the first time, and they suggested that I read, and then there were none, and I'm gonna be reading it definitely. But I am not really sure if I'll like him the second time. I really want to, but I'm not sure. But a lot of people love Agatha Christie. A lot of people started reading mystery in the first place for Agatha Christie. I think you may like it. If you want even more simple language, I'll suggest Arvind Narasimha's The Investigator series, which centers a detective called Arya, who's so handsome and dashing and everything amazing in this world. I totally love this book. The second book is already out. The third book is going to come real soon. I think it's going to be a great trilogy, and I hope that you're going to like it too. Since it's set in India and the language is simple, it's a great read for beginners as well. And if I'm speaking about Indian mystery novels, I just can't omit Feluda. I love Feluda and I love Bhumkesh Bakshi. I love Bhumkesh Bakshi more than Feluda though. However, I think Bhumkesh Bakshi translations are not available. I'll just check, and if I find, I'll just attach it in the comment below. But I don't think Bhumkesh Bakshi is available because the last time I checked, it wasn't. Feluda translations, however, are available in abundance. Make sure you read him because he's one of the greatest sleuths ever created by Satyajit Ray. Satyajit Ray is one of my favorite authors of all time. However, my favorite from Satyajit Ray is Professor Shonku, but that's a different story altogether. Let's leave it. In case you're reading about detectives from India, you just have to read the detectives that Bengali authors created, because guys, I'm not bragging or boasting here, but Bengali authors have created some of the best detectives of all time, and I am a Bengali, I know the feel, you know. So yeah, make sure you read some Bengali detective stories. And the last recommendation that I have for you guys is Rebecca by Daphne Du Maurier. I have not finished reading this book, but I'm reading it right now. It's too intriguing, and I know that I'm gonna love it because probably the best people in this world have told me that it's a great book. It has to be a great book. So far, I am so intrigued, and I just wonder what's happened to Rebecca. The plot centers around Mrs. De Winter, the second Mrs. De Winter, who marries Mr. De Winter, and she's come to his house. And the first Mrs. De Winter was Rebecca, and she's a really mysterious character. I don't know if she's good or bad, but I know she's very, very different from the rest. So far, I have had only good things to think and read in the book. I hope that you guys will like it too. If you're a mystery fan, I bet Rebecca will be worth your time. And these were the recommendations that I had for you guys. Now guys, I need to show you these three pretty bookmarks that Project sent me. And they say, read wide-eyed, read curiously, and read voraciously. And I love them. The quality is really great. It's not paper, it's not plastic, it's something in between. So it is waterproof, and in case you want some sturdy bookmarks, I think this is what you need. So I'll attach a link to their shop in the description below so that you can check their shop out in case you want to shop some bookish merchandise. And that will be all for today's video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a big thumbs up if you did. In case you have suggestions of mystery reads for me, because I want to read more. I have not read many, so I really need suggestions. Just leave them in the comment section below. And till my next video, bye-bye.